For the first time in 2021, it is Friday Night Baseball as we are here on the campus of Dennis Yarmouth High School for Friday Night Baseball between the Kentucky Cattleers and the first place Yarmouth-Dennis Red Sox. Hello again, everyone. Welcome to the Cattleers pregame show once again on the road. I'm your host, Tim Crowley. The second of three straight road games in the Eastern Division, starting last night, a loss in New Orleans for the Cattleers by a final of 6-4. They'll go to Brewster tomorrow night on Saturday, but for right now, it's Friday night. And why that's significant is you also see behind me with the YD Red Sox wearing those red jerseys with the Cape League logo on them. Those are to honor the armed forces that you'll see from every home team on Friday nights throughout the 2021 season. Let's take a look quick back to last night. It was the walks that, as we talked about in the postgame show, really hurt the Cattleers last night, especially early in the game, allowed Orleans to get out to a hot start, and they were able to hold on late to secure a win to jump them back to 2-1. But it's a new night for the Cattleers. They get an interesting look tonight and a true test early on in their season against the first place team in YD. And on the mound for them, it's something that you really want to keep an eye on, especially when you're in YD. This has been a pitcher's paradise over the last decade or so in terms of catapulting guys to the big leagues. Names like Shane Bieber, Walker Buehler, and for the Red Sox fans, Chris Sale, all getting their start on the field behind me. And tonight it's going to be Zach Jacobs out of Cal Riverside. We've talked a lot about these Cal schools. It continues tonight for the Red Sox. Was 1-6 with a 5.18 ERA in 2021, but was really solid in 2020 prior to the pandemic shutdown, going 2-2 with a 2.57 ERA. Encountering with them for Kituit, it's going to be Ryan Long out of Pomona College, was a two-time Emerald City MVP and is really looking to make his jump on the mound tonight in his first start for Kituit. Across his college career, has been pretty successful, 8-2 with a 3.70 ERA. He looks to right the ship and end this little bit of a mini skid for the Cattleers tonight. Before we move on to Carrycast, let's take a listen in back to Orleans last night when our own Lauren Kirkley met with Coach Roberts after the loss.
Coach, after an early deficit, what kind of boost did Hamilton Oliver give you coming out of the bullpen?
He really did a great job, and he what you call, hold him in check until we can score some runs. And that's the first time Hamilton's been out there. And again, first week of the season, trying to get everybody in the lineup. And like Brett Roberts tonight, after coming in the other night at Hyannis, just he wasn't in the starting lineup. You know, got a couple base hits tonight. So again, we're looking at everybody, but I thought Hamilton did a great job to give us a chance to get back in it. I think it was 4-0 when he came in. We got it back to 4-3. So he had a really good evening.
After going 0-6 in the first two games, Brooks Baldwin seems to be swinging the bat a lot better. What kind of changes did you see in his approach?
Well, I don't think he's any changes. I think guys get comfortable. We come in and do extra hitting every single day. And Brooks is what I call an old-fashioned baseball player. He's kind of a country slasher a little bit. I haven't helped him any. I haven't said anything to him about his hitting. He's got beautiful hand action, and he had a really good night tonight.
Heading into game two of this three-game road stretch, what is your message to the team?
Well, again, my message is pretty consistent. If you look up on the board after the game or look in the box score and there's no errors, no pass balls, no wild pitches, and hopefully no walks, maybe one in there, with our offense, we'll win. So you got to clean it up a little bit. And right now, the Hyannis game, we were fine in the game we got rained out against Bourne. We played really well. But the Hyannis game and tonight, as you could tell, we were up 3-0 Hyannis. We gave some runs back easily without really many hits. Tonight we gave them three runs on one hit. And so we just got to clean it up a little bit. And we're a veteran team. Cohen's a veteran pitcher, and, you know, he's got to do a better job of throwing strikes. But we'll be fine. I like our club. As you've seen, we battle like crazy. So we'll be okay.
Thanks, Coach. All right, thanks. From Eldridge Park, Lauren Kirkley.
Back-to-back road losses for Kituit brings us to the famous Red Wilson Field, where the Cattleers battle the YD Red Sox tonight. Hello again, everybody. I'm Chris Carey, joined by my brother Stephen Carey for another edition of Carrycast. A three-run rally in the sixth wasn't enough to propel the Cattleers past the Orleans Firebirds at Eldridge Park last night. Now they face the number one team in the East, the YD Red Sox. Should be a good one tonight, Chris. And the Cattleers' offense over the last three games has been successful, but they haven't put together a great performance like Game 1 at Lowell Park. Stephen, what do you see from this team and what needs to be addressed?
Well, we've addressed relief pitching, but starting pitching hasn't been great either. No starter has gotten out of the third inning. That can't happen tonight against the number one team in the East if the Cattleers want to get their second win of the season.
And now they're facing a team that lost 7-1 on the road against the Wareham Gateman, and they'll be greeted by a new pitcher from the Division III ranks in Ryan Long. What do you see from this guy, and what does he bring to the table for the Cattleers tonight?
Well, he walks into a perfect situation, both teams looking to build momentum. Ryan Long, one of the nicest guys on the Kettleers. I'm rooting really hard for him. Division III out of Pomona College in California. He's not going to win you the game, but he's not going to lose it either. Fastball, tall, lanky right-hander, and it's going to be fun to watch him on the mound tonight.
Friday Night Baseball, Cotuit and Yarmouth Dennis, two of the most popular teams on the Cape, up next.
Chris and Steph, thanks so much. Before we wrap up the Kettleers pregame show, here are three keys to get this team back to 500 with a win tonight. Number one is put the ball in the air. It's a little bit different of an outfield dimension. It's pretty straight all the way across and just 352 to center field, a little bit different than the 434 that we saw last night to dead center in that triangle in Orleans. If you get the ball in the air, there's a little bit of an outward breeze tonight, a little bit of a cloudy Friday night. The gusts are out. See if you can get one in the air and try to get one into this wide east stream and see if the Kettleers can put a couple out tonight. Second one is throwing strikes. As we mentioned at the start of the show, it was the walks last night that killed the Kettleers from the beginning. Throwing strikes and keeping the Red Sox off of the bases by way of a base on balls is going to be huge for this pitching staff to try to improve tonight. And finally, number three, we know Coach Roberts, we know this system is a group that likes to run. Try to challenge this catching staff tonight for YD. We know this is a team that can run a little bit. Try to make some plays on the bases, particularly late in the games. That's when this offense has needed the jolt the most. Well, that'll do it for the Kettleers pregame show here on a Friday night. A huge thanks to Chris and Stefan, Carrie Cast, and throwing it back to Lauren from her interview last night. We'll be joined after the game by Lauren Kirkley for our postgame show, where she'll also talk to Coach Roberts. That will be more next on YouTube here on the Kettleers Digital Network. We'll be right back.